Hi there, and welcome to episode number 2 of Digitech. Today we are going to demonstrate the use of LPSpice circuit simulator to create and simulate our own circuits on any computer, basically, because this is a very lightweight program. It works and it is nice, used by both hobbyists and professionals. You can get it like this way from Linear Technology. Download any version that matches your operating system, and I highly suggest reading LPSpice Getting Started Guide. It's a PDF document, very nice, although being very old right now. Okay, now I assume you have already acquired LPSpice, you have downloaded it and installed it. Once you open it, you need to create a new document, appear new schematic, and save it. Save it anywhere you like. Now, to create our circuit, we have to use these components which we will be using all the time. This is the main component, the selection tool. You can search for any component that you want, especially those who are from linear technology, op-amps and resistors and diodes, zeners, whatever. Now, when you select a component like that, you can put it by left-clicking on the schematic sheet and left click and left click until you are finished. Now, when you are finished, you can click right click to disable this tool. Now, we don't need all of these voltage sources, so we press the delete button and press left click and left click, then right click. Now, we need to add to make a resistor divider, a very simple circuit. So we click on resistors, put one here and one here. Okay, right click. Now we need to match between them using this tool, which is the wiring tool. Left click until you are finished. Now notice that we don't have any ground circle, any ground point, or any ground reference. So we're gonna use this button right here, this tool, ground, and put a ground right here. Now, for tidying this up, we put this wire right here as a probe. So we can use this tool, which is the label tool, to put a label for this particular node. We can label it like a V underscore out and attach it to here, so we can know that this is the name of this node. And by all means, put this V input label on here. Okay, now we have to check for our circuit using this method by right clicking on V1, choose a value, let's call it 10 volts. Right click on resistors, create 10k, which is 10,000 ohms, and here also 10k. You can use 10 amp for milli, U for micro, meg for mega, and of course k for kilo or 1000. Now this voltage divider divides this voltage by a half, so we expect to see 5 volts right here. Click save. Now this, for example, adds a diode. Now before putting this diode, for example, we want to rotate this diode. Click Ctrl R. As you can see, you can rotate this diode. Now if you press Ctrl E, you will mirror this diode right here. You mirror it over its own axis, which is very helpful when using op-amps in this circuit. Now, if you are happy with this configuration, you can press left click, so you can add it, but we won't be using it, so delete. Okay, save. Now, I guess the circuit is complete. We have explained all of these components, most of them. By the way, this is the rotate tool, and this is the mirror tool. Control R, Control E. This is the redo or undo, which leaves us with these two. The move tool, when you select a component using a move tool, and move it away, you can as you can see, detach it from whatever connections that it has and put it on another location. Right click to the disable that. While the drag tool, you can put here and drag the components with all connections that are on it. Okay, this tool is for creating inductors, and this one is for capacitors we will not be using now. This tool is for adding a text, which means any text, like this one, VG Tech Healthy Spice Tutorial. Okay, and put it, for example, right here. Now, as you can see, stuff are going out of the screen. This one right here, zoom until everything we put is in the screen. Save, and now we are ready to simulate the circuit. Press simulate, now edit simulation command, which is very important. Now these tabs represents the all types of simulations that you can do with LTSpice. Namely, the best one is transient response, which is the default one, everyone uses it. And this is AC analysis for loop compensation, and the other DC sweep, noise, DC transfer, operation point, whatever. You can watch many videos made by people on each and every one of them. Today, let's focus on transient response. This calculates the currents and the voltages on all your nodes and components for a set period of time, from 0 seconds to, let's say, 1 millisecond, which is a nice period. Putting something like 1 second or 2 seconds is actually very much. You can now press OK. Now you can have this line, which is called the dot command, dot trans 1m, put it anywhere else, like right here, and save. This means you tell LTSpice that you want transient response and 1 millisecond time. Save and press run. Okay. Now you have this this plot right here. It represents whatever you can pick from here. If you want the V input, you can put right here, and you have this red probe. Okay, now click on it and it displays the value in this plot right here. You can click and it is 10 volts. You can move this around if you have noise and you want to check every point. Now if you want the output voltage, you can click here and it adds it right here. V out is 5 volts and V input is 10 volts. You can click, zoom to it to see all the waveform, and go to range Y axis to put a suitable range which presents them all. Now, for example, if you don't want this to be to appear here, you can right click on it, delete this text. Now, what if you want to view the current consumed by this R1? Put the cursor right here and left click. You have the current, which is around 500 microamps, which is pretty much what we expected, and it has this IR1. It is the blue line. It is now right here, 500 microamps. But as you can see, using voltages and currents on the same plot, it's kind of annoying. So you want to delete this one and right click, add plot plane, so we can make another one. Put right here, click right here on your left mouse, and then another one right here. So you have now one for currents and one for voltages. You can open this up, you can make auto range Y axis if you have multiple currents and multiple voltages, like for example, having I2, which is basically the same current. Okay, very nice. You can delete this one and press this button to tile them again. Now, this is for a very simple circuit, which is the voltage divider. Now, we will try another circuit, which is somehow represent a half-wave bridge rectifier. Adding these components. Let's complete the circuit first and then add whatever components that we can. Let's delay this period right here. Put a load, for example, 10 ohms. And here, if you put advanced, you now have many options. For a DC value like 10 volts, you can put it right here and use none. But we don't want that. This one is a pulse, which means like a PWM signal, on time and off time. Square wave pulse signal, this is a sine wave, which we will be using. This one also has its own options. This one right here, you can specify exactly the type of wave that you have, which is a regular wave, like from 0 to 1 millisecond, 0 volts, and up to 3 milliseconds, 10 volts, then from 3 milliseconds to, say, 10 milliseconds, minus 15 volts, or whatever you like, you can write them in this table. Today, we will use a sine wave to create DC offset. We don't want any DC offset. AC amplitude of 10 volts, frequency, let's say 10 kilohertz, no delay, no anything like that, we don't want anything. Press OK. Simulation command, 1 millisecond, put it right here, save, nice, and now let's simulate, run. As you can see, this is the AC wave that we have expected, 10 amplitude, 10 kilohertz. You can calculate the period from here to here. And now you can see that the current actually aligns very well with the voltage signal, and it is peaking at what, 1 amp. Now you can delete this one, and let's focus right here. I want to add a diode, Ctrl R, then Ctrl E. Now, this diode will only allow the positive edge of this signal to pass. So, for example, this will pass, but this will never pass. Now, click save, click simulate. Okay, this is the voltage right here. What about the voltage right here? As you can see, the negative cycle is no longer, which means that the current is also the same, peaking at, let's say, peak current of roughly 913 milliamps. Now increase this, for example, to 11 volts, simulation run, so we can get something like 1 amp of current. Now, if you want to, by the way, if you left click on a blank space and put and drag your mouse, you will drag the schematic with you. Now, delete this one right here. Now, you can put a capacitor to act like a filter and put something like 100 microfarad for this capacitor, say, run. Okay, this is the input voltage, and watch the output voltage. It is effectively a single diode or half bridge wave rectifier. Now, the output, by the way, if you double click on a single node, you will put it alone and discard any other nodes or voltages or anything on this plot. Now, you can see that it tries to filter out this signal, but you can see the 100 microfarad is too little. Let's increase it to a value of 1000 microfarad, which is very useful when you use switching power supplies. Simulate, and you can see now that it is much, much more smoother. You can see only this very few ripple around. If you want to see how much value, you can click and drag this type of the wave, and it will magnify on it. You can see it is like 10.0, and this is here around 10. You can see it's roughly roughly 90 milli volts or something. If you want to return to the previous zoom, you can zoom to it. Okay, and now you can see that you can manipulate whatever values you like to gain the response or the circuit that you want. There is nothing left to say about basic configurations of LPSpice components, basic components. Now, if you want other components, you can always go right here and select, for example, op amp, something famous like 1013 op amp, precision of operational amplifier. Of course, all of these are LT models. You can pretty much be sure that this, for example, LT1007 will function exactly as the true part. And of course, you can make as many circuits as you want, and pretty much they will be accurate as long as you do it properly and expect what you have in real world. For example, if you right click on this diode, pick new diode, you can select one of these. Let's call it IN1914 silicon diode, or for example, pick this one, sort them on average amps. This Schottky diode that has 25 amps, you can search for it online, and now it is a Schottky diode. Remove that. We want a 10 volts DC, very simple. No need. Oh, sorry. Now, there is no need for this capacitor as I have deleted it. Now, watch what will happen when this circuit is on. Okay. Let's increase simulation time. Make it 10 milliseconds. Save. Run. Let's pick a new diode. This is 10 volts input, and we have something like 9.2 or 9.1 voltage. Now, when you press like here, you have this voltage with respect to ground. But what if you want to measure the drop voltage or the difference between two nodes, not just the ground? Let's try to do that. Click here and keep clicking on the left mouse button and then drag. And once this turns or select the other one, just release it. And now you have somehow 800 millivolts drop voltage around this voltage. And don't be confused by this line, because this is from 816.8. 2.82, which is in order of 10 microvolts, which will be actually nothing. So you can be pretty sure that this diode will give you 0.816 volts drop voltage between the 10 volts and the output. Now, output current is actually the same as the output voltage. Let's try add a capacitor again to see what type of effect will it have. Make it 1 micro. Back. This now I became a very flat line. Why? Because this voltage now is no longer this line that is ramping up, because the capacitor has already charged, and you can have very stable voltage of the nominal 9.18 volt, caused by the drop voltage by this by this diode right here. Notice that this drop voltage is around 0.816 and this one is 9.18. Okay, I hope this tutorial was very useful, and if you have any question, any questions or any ideas that you want me to explain in LPSpice or any other type of videos, please be sure to put it in the YouTube comments and click share and subscribe, and I hope I will see you next time.